Hi there, welcome to Sheetgo's YouTube channel. In this video, I'll show you how to use Sheetgo's inventory lending workflow template for Excel. The template is ideal for libraries, schools, IT departments, or rental and hire businesses, because it gives you a simple way to track borrowed and returned items and automate your inventory systems. Unlike a standard spreadsheet template, this workflow consists of three separate but connected Excel files, and data flows between them via Sheetgo connections. Sheetgo connections let you automate data transfer between different files, so that means that you can create your own inventory control system without any specialist software, just spreadsheets. A spreadsheet-based system is very scalable. If you use spreadsheets to manage other parts of your business, such as purchasing or budgeting, you can connect those files to your inventory lending workflow and create an integrated data management system. When you have multiple people working in the same spreadsheet, it can become very large and slow, and there's also a higher risk of making mistakes if you check items in and out in the same spreadsheet. An automated workflow with separate files, on the other hand, is lighter to process and more reliable. Now let me show you how it works. The Sheetgo Inventory Lending workflow contains three Excel files. First of all, staff have a designated spreadsheet to check returned items in. In a separate spreadsheet, the staff responsible for lending items can check items out. Administrators or managers then get an automated overview of all available items in the master sheet and dashboard. This can help you identify where you need to purchase more equipment or trace missing items that haven't been returned yet. Now let's set up your system. To install the inventory lending workflow, click the link that I'll put in the video description below. You'll enter this screen in the Sheetgo web application where you can sign in with your Google, Dropbox or Microsoft account. Let me sign in with Microsoft. There we go, here you can now click on Install Template and the drop-down will show you the following options. You can install the template for Google Sheets on Google Drive, but of course we want to install the template for Excel, and we're going to do that on SharePoint. Let's click right here. Give Sheetgo a few seconds to create the copies of the Excel files and add it to your personal drive. That's it, Sheetgo installed the template for you, and here we are in the overview of your inventory lending workflow. First of all, you see with how many people you share this workflow, and you can add more colleagues in the share settings right here. Below defines how many files we have in this workflow. We have three files, so the check-in, the checkout, and our master sheet, and these are connected with four connections. Lastly, the automation schedule right here shows you if the workflow is finished running, when it last ran, if you have your automatic updates set on, and you can turn them on right here, and how many updates it uses in each run. If you then open the workflow overview right here, you go to the second tab of our workflow where you can get a closer look and of course also edit your connections and your files. So here we can take a closer look at the connections and the files. We see our four connections right here, the check-in, check-out, items database and the current out items. And here you can see them visually as well. The other tab is the Files tab, where you see the check-in spreadsheet, check-out spreadsheet, and the master sheet. Let me open the master sheet for you. As you can see, the spreadsheet opens in a new tab in your browser, but you can always edit it from the desktop app as well. Just make sure that your files are automatically synced to your cloud storage, and you can work on them in the desktop app as well. As you can see, we have an Instructions tab right here. Here you can follow the steps a bit of how to use the template, but the main thing we have, of course, is our dashboard, where you can see how many items in total you have, how many items are in stock and available, items out by borrower, and which items currently are out. These are the graphs in your dashboard. Then the only thing you need to do here is input your item database. As you can see, we have some sample data right here that you can simply delete and fill out with your own. The spreadsheet gives you this current inventory list where you can see how much of every item is still available. And it brings the connections from the check-in and the check-in spreadsheets right here as well. Let me show you check-in and check-out and how to use them. Let's go back to the workflow and open the check-in and the check-out spreadsheet. Do not forget to share the spreadsheet with the person responsible for checking items in and checking items out, of course, in the other spreadsheets. As you can see, these spreadsheets have some instructions as well. And then in the check-in spreadsheet, we simply have our check-in tab right here, where you of course delete the sample data and fill out your own. Same for the checkout. Delete this data and fill it out with your own. Once you've shared these spreadsheets with the people responsible and they filled out their information, you can click run right here inside Sheetgo to update that data inside your master sheet. If you do not want to do that manually every time you need to see updated information, you click on automate right here and schedule automatic updates. For example, once a day between 5 and 6 p.m. on every weekday. Turn off any days that you won't look at them, for example. Click save right here and you schedule automatic updates. If you have any other files to connect to this workflow, you can do that right here. And don't forget to share the workflow with other inventory managers or people who need to get insights into your inventory control. That's it. That's how you work with Sheetgo's inventory lending template for Excel. If you have any questions about this, please do not hesitate to comment below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more step-by-step tutorials. Thank you very much.